Thank you.
Hello and welcome to another trip report. I'm sitting in a limousine provided by Etihad and I'm on my way to Abu Dhabi International Airport. Today's flight is going to be on Etihad Airways, an Airbus 380, and I'll be sitting in first class this time. So I'm very much looking forward to my flight, and let's go! For first class guests, Etihad has a designated lounge and spa in Terminal 3. Right at the entrance, you are offered some Arabian coffee, and I think in these baskets there were dates and there was some induced water as well. The lounge looks cozy and there were not too many people. I especially like the view. As an aviation geek, I easily can spend a couple of hours at an airport, especially with such a view, and even more especially if I can enjoy the view from such a lounge with some tea and cookies. It's now approximately 9 in the morning, so it's breakfast time. Beside the a la carte table service, Etihad offers this exquisite looking buffet. From the a la carte menu, I could have had all kinds of eggs with bacon, beans, sausage and many other options. But I was not quite as hungry, so I only had something small and sweet. What I have never seen before in a lounge is a cigar and cognac room. This room is like an oval island in the middle of the lounge and offers a selection of spirits. Not sure if it's cognac or whiskey or both, as I'm not an expert and I'm usually happy with some Jameson. And there's also a selection of cigars, about which I know even less. But there's a cigar menu with some prices, so I guess that's not free of charge. But if you are an expert on that, check it out. Another feature I've never seen before is this relaxation room with this massive screen that shows a different animation every few minutes while you sit on a comfortable seat. So it's time to travel now. I am now at the gate and this is my ride today, an Etihad Airbus 380, which had its first flight in October 2016. And it has 415 seats in economy class, 70 seats in business class and 11 seats in first class. As a first class passenger, I was put into a waiting area separated from the other people. Boarding started very much on time, so let the fun begin. As you can see, this massive bird of an Airbus 380 is connected to two jet bridges, one for the economy class on the lower deck and one for the first and business class on the upper deck. Here I am in my Etihad first class apartment. How exciting! I am in apartment 3K today, which has a seat on the window side. My seat is facing backwards, but I've been told that I would not feel any difference whether I fly facing forwards or backwards. So let's find out. As you can see, each apartment is alternating facing forward and backward, and also the ladder color is changing depending on the seat row. Underneath the ottoman, which can be extended to a bed, you find a lot of storage room. There's also the bed blanket and linen. More about the bed I show later. There is also this small closet for hanging the coat or jacket, which I find super practical. For the pre-departure drink, I opted for a lemon mint water, which came along with a hot hand towel and some dates. Cheers to a wonderful flight ahead. While I had my pre-departure drink, the onboard cook came along with a massive tin jug and some cups to offer this delicious Arabian coffee. So let's have a look at some features and amenities of this first class apartment. We have this nice Etihad cushion and a flexible headrest. And these are the seat controls, which are also found in more detail inside the armrest via a touchscreen. There's also some extra storage space. Here I can adjust the firmness of my seat. And I also can adjust, for example, the lights or the window blinds. I'm going to show you the dining table now, which is located inside the left armrest. It is quite easy to slide it out of its stored position. However, I noticed that the table is surprisingly heavy. But it also is quite big, as you can see. What I like especially is that you can push the table enough forward so that you can dig out of the seat if needed, without having to fold back the table. I think it's a smart design. The window blinds can be operated from the seat like this. And there are two layers of shades, as you can see. But you also can operate each window individually, directly at the window. And now check this out. Part of the privacy wall between two apartments can be stowed away, and you basically get a two-bedroom apartment. These two ladder benches can be turned into beds, so you even get a double bed, in case that is what you want when you travel with your partner all over. Otherwise, when you travel alone, the privacy wall is usually closed. The Etihad first class apartment of course is meant for one person, however the ladder bench has two additional sets of seat belts, which means you can have up to two guests in your apartment, but not during takeoff and landing. And this is one of the power outlets, which you can easily reach when you lay in bed. In my apartment I also find two lamps, one at the windows and one next to the doors. And both of them have four different light intensity settings. And right above the seat there is also a reading lamp, which is quite high up though, but it works well. And of course there is also a safety card for this Airbus 380. This is one of two identical entertainment system controllers, the other one is next to the bed, which basically mirrors the big TV screen which I have in front of me. Of course, I could take the controller from the wall as it is connected to a cable, but while holding the camera it was a bit easier for me at the moment to use it like this. Now I don't have to hold the camera, so I can take the entertainment system controller out of the socket. By the way, there are more power outlets, like those USB ports, an HDMI port, and this socket I think is for the noise cancelling headset. And as I mentioned, there is another controller next to the bench, which becomes a bed. Once you are in bed, all the main controls are within your reach, like this light and window shades control, as well as the socket for the noise cancelling headphones. And there is a fourth seatbelt in this apartment, which can be used while you sleep.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard Etihad Airways. Please pay attention as we demonstrate the safety features of this aircraft. Your seatbelt must be fastened whenever. When instructed by the crew, remove it from its stowage, take it out of the cover, and place.
So it's time to start our journey towards London Heathrow, and I am already very much looking forward to enjoy the food and the amenities of this Etihad first class apartment. In the background you can see Abu Dhabi's new midfield terminal building, or called MTB, which is about to open very soon. It will be able to handle a stunning 45 million passengers annually. And Etihad plans to open a new first class lounge in there, which is supposed to become very stunning, I was told. Now is a good time to check out the amenities in this first class apartment. We have this super fluffy blanket and also this fancy looking Acqua di Parma amenity kit. It contains a plush sleeping mask, an Acqua di Parma body lotion, toothbrush and toothpaste, a lip balm, and in this tiny little bottle I got some Acqua di Parma colonia. And that was it. And of course the lounge slippers. And this is the most exciting goodie, the Etihad first class pyjama. This apartment offers a spacious mirror cupboard, which probably is more useful for female guests in some cases, but I find it practical to put the amenities in there. This cupboard has some elastic fitters on the side, so you can even strap in some of your goodies. Let's check out the headphones now. It comes with this branded hard case. But oh no, it is empty. But no worries, come with me. I show you another feature of this apartment, which is this small corner cupboard right next to the seat, which is designed to hold the headset. It is now in there because I unpacked the headset earlier already. And there is more storage room here. And what's pretty cool, there is a mini bar right next to the seat with some soda, coke and water. Now I want some extra privacy, so I just close these sliding doors. It's time to check out the menu before the onboard cook comes to take the orders. The so-called first seller drinks menu contains Charles Heidsieck champagne, a choice of white and red wine, many different cocktails and spirits, and of course also regular stuff like coffee, soft drinks and tea. And this is the exciting dining menu. If you want to read it, just press the pause button. What I'm definitely going for is the caviar serving. On the next side is the lounge and grill menu, which is also super exciting. As I mentioned before, Etihad has an onboard chef and he personally took the order from me and he was happy with any kind of special requests. What a service! While the chef is preparing my lunch, I could serve a mocktail as it was a bit early for me personally for alcohol. And it came with some nuts, olives and pickled vegetables. Yes, here it is, the Etihad signature caviar service. And as it is normal with high-end restaurants, you get a sorbet in between the courses. I didn't record my appetizer, which was a pumpkin soup, but here comes my tenderloin beef, medium rare, as I like it best. The chef explained to me how difficult it is to have a meat prepared perfectly with an aircraft griddle. Well, my dish was fabulous. Now let's have a look at the bathroom, which is located at the very front of the Airbus 380. Look how big it is. I think it's the most spacious bathroom I've ever seen on an aircraft. There are a number of Acqua di Parma toiletries, such as soap, body lotion and other creams. And you can choose between cotton towels or the regular paper ones. And have you ever seen a glass sink like this on an aircraft before? I think that's pretty stylish. And beside a full-size mirror, there are also two coat hooks if needed. Like back in the glory days of aviation, Etihad offers a lounge on their Airbus 380, which is located on the upper deck between the first and the business class. The lounge consists of two semi-circular leather couches with armrests that also offer quite many power sockets. Behind one of the benches is a well-stocked bar with a multitude of wines, champagne and spirits. And in case you get hungry while you are watching live football on one of the two big screens in the lounge, or while you are socializing with fellow passengers, just tell the chef what you like and he will prepare it for you, even if it is a steak with fries. I still want to show you how the bed in the first class apartment looks like when this Ottoman bench is lowered to a flat bed. I'm using a clip from an earlier flight with Etihad because on this flight to London I didn't use the bed. Also note the TV is on the wall, however It is possible to move it out of the wall and turn it 90 degrees so you can watch a movie while you are laying in bed. And for a good night's sleep, you can lower the window blinds right from the privacy wall. No need to stand up. Have I mentioned that this first class apartment is very spacious? I'm sure I did. It's simply impressive. A bit earlier I showed you the bed with a clip from an earlier flight with Etihad, but I didn't show how the Ottoman bench is turned into a flat surface. It's done with the press of one button, press and hold, and here you go. And all the blankets and linen are stored right underneath the Ottoman. The entertainment system can be entirely controlled with the handheld device, so I can select a movie or use one of the other services such as games, TV shows, live TV, music, radio, kids channel, news feeds, flight path and so on. Once you have selected something, you can project your choice onto the main TV screen. I saved one of the highlights of this first class product for the end of this video, which is the shower. It is located in one of the front bathrooms, which also comes with cotton hand towels, all the creams, lotions and soaps, the usual sink and toilet, but all kept in a dark tone. And voila, this is the onboard shower. You will be provided with 5 minutes of hot or cold water, towels, shampoo, shower gels and conditioner, and the shower head is fixed installed on the very top. This is an indicator which will glow green, yellow and red depending how much time left for the water running. On this flight I didn't take a shower as I had one this morning, but I have taken one on my previous Etihad flights. I will provide my shower experience on another video later this year with even more additional information about this Etihad first class product. Otherwise, this flight report is becoming too long, so please subscribe to my channel not to miss out on my future videos. Welcome to London Heathrow. This was the last one of a series of flights with Etihad, and I must say, this first class experience was one of my highlights of my many years of flying around the globe. I truly hope I will be able to enjoy such a luxurious and comfortable flight again sometime in the future.